मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम टू जीकेआरयू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। माय नेम इज कुशल पांडे एंड आई विल टीचिंग यू इंग्लिश। सो आवर फर्स्ट लेसन इज, फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज एलिस एंड द माउस। ओके, सो बिफोर गोइंग टू दिस न्यू चैप्टर लेट्स पिक आउट सम न्यू वर्ड्स, दैट इज प्रोसिक्यूट, स्टार्ट लीगल प्रोसीडिंग्स, डिनायल, रिफ्यूजल, ऑफेंडेड, फेल्ट, इंसल्टेड, snappishly, angrily. Okay, so Alice and the Mouse, it is a small extract, it is a small extract from Lewis Carroll's Alice and the Mouse is a small story. It is a small extract taken from Lewis Carroll's novels, that is Alice Adventures in the Wonderland, which is published in the year 1871. So it is a small story about a fantastic story about a young girl named Alice, okay, who follows a rabbit. And what did she find? She discovers a long passage with lots of doors. As we know that the mouse, they dig a long tunnel and numerous doors are there when they dig a hole. As we have to build our house, we make different rooms and different rooms have different doors. So as like us, the mouse dig a hole and in that hole he discovers, he makes lot of doors which finds difficult for other living creatures to get inside. Okay, so Alice chases down that rabbit and she finds a golden key that could fit that tiny door. And beyond that door, there is a beautiful garden where she wanted to go. So during his chase, she finds a golden key that could fit the tiny door. And beyond the door, there is a beautiful garden where Alice wanted to go. But there was a problem. What was the problem? The problem was that Alice was much taller as compared to that tiny door. Okay. Though Alice wanted to go there, but she can't because the door is only 15 inches, which is much, much smaller than Alice. So in order to get into that door, she should turn into a teeny little girl so that she could get inside it. So in that moment, she dreamt how to get inside that hole. So in that moment, she found a bottle, water bottle, which was kept on the table. And on that water bottle, it was written that drink me. So when Alice drink that water, she became a small tiny girl, which was much smaller than that door, around 10 inches. Okay. But again she find difficult to open the door. How she find difficult? Because she had kept the golden key on the table. And as she was a very little girl, she can't reach to the table. That's why it was a big problem, very big problem for her to get back that keys. So she cried there. So she, for that moment, after some time, thought that how can she get back those keys. Again, after going to some distances, there was a cake. Okay, there was a cake lying on the ground. Okay, so in that cake it was written a Timmy. So when Alice ate that cake, she became a 9 feet tall girl as usual as he was earlier. Okay, so as earlier as she was, she became 9 feet tall girl. Okay. Then again it was a problem for her to get into that garden or get into that door, because she was 9 feet tall as previously she was. Okay, so in order to go there, she will have to become a little teddy girl. So she cried loudly. She cried for some time, and after some time, when she came near a friend, she got shrink into a little girl. So in this way, she get the golden key and get to that teeny door, and finally she opened the door and found a beautiful garden beyond that door. Okay. So when she entered the door, she find herself that she was swimming in a pool. So where does that pool comes from? As you know that, as I told you that, before shrinking to a little girl, she was 9 feet tall girl, and she was crying to become a small girl. So at that time she was crying, and her tears become a large pool. Her tears become a large pool, and when she sink into a teeny girl, she find herself that she was swimming in that tears of pool. So suddenly, when she was swimming there, so suddenly she heard something splashing sound, and that was some other living creatures. She thought that some other living creatures, that might be hippopotamus or your walrus, has come into that pond, because hippopotamus, walruses, these are all sea animals because they live in sea. So for few moments she thought that it might be your a hippopotamus or a walrus who had come into the pond or is swimming in the pond. Okay. So afterward she turned around, and when she turned around, she saw that a small rabbit, okay, small mouse was swimming in that pond. Okay. So as Alice was new and she find that she herself is the only person who is living, who is human person. Rest all of the animals, those who were present there, they were all animals. So Alice was very awkward in that situation. Okay. So when she was swimming in that pool, she found a small mouse who also slipped into that pond. So at first Alice wanted to talk with the mouse, but she didn't, because she thought that for a few moments she thought that was it the right time to talk with the mouse. Alice thought carefully. So actually for her everything was out of the way, because she was completely new there. She didn't know anything about that place, about the creatures. So she thought carefully and thought that was it the right time to speak or to talk with the mouse, because she wanted to get out of that pool. So in that moment, what happens? The mouse was also a new creature to Alice, and for Alice, mouse also was a new creature. So when Alice asked mouse that, "Oh mouse, do you know the way out of the pool?" And Alice asked mouse, the mouse got shivered. So for the first time, the mouse didn't pay attention towards the words of Alice, because the mouse was completely new to Alice. So it didn't find any, so it didn't pay any attention to Alice's words. For the next time, when Alice told that, "Oh mouse, could you please help me out of the pool, because I have been swimming here for many times. for hours. For an hours I have been swimming here. So I want to get out of this pool. Alice asks the mouse gently. Mouse looked at the Alice inquisitively, curiously, and there was no and the mouse didn't pay any attention towards Alice. So at that moment, Alice thought that perhaps the mouse didn't understand her words. So she make a sound. She began to talk in another language, which was written in her French book in the first edition, that was Ostomach. Ostomachat was the first sentence written in her French book. So when she said these words, the mouse got shivered, the mouse got chilled. He was very afraid of listening this word. So perhaps it might be the word that might be related to some living creatures who can kill that mouse, or maybe the mouse enemies. So it may be the word related to cat. So the mouse suddenly leap out of water and shivered with fright. Okay. So when Alice used the word Ostomachat, the mouse began to shiver. The mouse was completely afraid of that word. So when Alice saw that the mouse was afraid, she began to pardon. She said, "I'm extremely sorry for that. If I had hurt your feelings." So the mouse replied that it doesn't mean that you can say something that will hurt me. Okay. So the mouse was completely afraid of that words. So Alice told the mouse that perhaps you may not like the cats, in a soothing tone. So don't be angry. Again she asked mouse that, "Are you fond of dogs? Do you like dogs?" On listening that, the mouse was completely shivered. The mouse was completely afraid, and he began to swim away from her. On seeing that, Alice cried and told the mouse that, "Please, mouse, do come back. We want to get out of the pool, and you are the only creatures to whom I have seen, and no one is here to look after me. Not a single little creature is present who can help me out of the pool, and you are the only creatures who can help me. So please come back. I won't say you anything about dogs, cats, or other creatures. Please come back and help me out." So in this way, Alice called the mouse, and they both come together and come together out of the pool near the Shishu. So when both of them come together near the seashore, Alice asked mouse that how he had come into the pond, that how he got drowned into the pond, and what was his story. Actually, Alice wanted to know about the story of mouse. So the mouse started telling his story, that how he get into that pond, or about his sad story. So the mouse began to listen to Alice. So at the time of listening, At the time of telling this story, the mouse told that my tail is a long tail. So here Alice thought that the meaning of tail is different. Actually, the Alice thought that a thought of about mouse tail, but the mouse wanted to tell about that tail, that story. But Alice looked at mouse tails and told that, why are you sad about your tail? It is a good one. Then why are you so tense about your tail? Luckily, mouse wanted to tell about his story, not about his poor tail. Okay. So when mouse was trying to say his story, Alice didn't pay attention towards his story. So when mouse saw that Alice didn't pay attention towards his story, he was very angry. He was very angry that she was not listening his story. So what he did? He was very angry and wanted to go away from that place. But apart from mouse and Alice, there were some small creatures, those who were listening the story of the mouse, and they were carefully listening that story because it was this interesting story of the mouse. So when mouse started walking away from that place, the other creatures were present there. They told chorusly that, please mouse, don't go, please finish your story, because we want to listen your story. So all of them requested the mouse that they wanted to listen the story, but the mouse was completely depressed and he went out of that place. So taking this opportunity, one of the crabs, we can find different creatures near the sea, near the river, like your crabs, your frogs, and some small other living creatures. So from that creatures, one crab told her daughter that let this lesson be completed here itself and come back home, please. So on listening this, daughter told her mother that, please ma, let it be, don't call me, I want to listen the story of the mouse. So in that moment, Alice wished about her pet, wished that, I wish I had our Dina who could fetch the mouse. So the rest of the creatures, those who are present there, they asked about that pet, that whether what kind of pet did Alice had. So Alice replied that it is her dog. It is her dog who could fetch the mouse and bring it back to her to complete his story. So when Alice Pig told about her pet, everyone got scared. It created a sensation among the party, because there were lots of creatures present there who were listening the story of the mouse. So as we know that all the cats, dogs, they catch birds, they catch different or other animals. animals and ate them. So when the members, when the members that are present there, when they listen that it is her pet, the dog is her pet, they moved away quickly from that place because they knew that these are all fascinating animals. They can kill any other animals and eat them. So when they listen, they moved away from that place. And once again, Alice got alone in there. So before he was alone, but the small creatures, the small mouse came to join her. They both lived together for some minutes, for some times. But after some time, mouse left her away. And the members, the party members who were present there, they also left Alice. And Alice became completely alone. No one was there with her, could share her thoughts, could share her story. So at that moment, Alice thought that if she had not missed about her Dina, about her pet, no one will go to their home. They all will be with her. So it was the mistake which she did, and she paid for it. So after some time, when she was sitting there, a small pattering sound came to her ear. So at that time, Alice thought that perhaps it might be the mouse who is coming, but it wasn't so. The mouse left that place and other party members left that place, and Alice was alone in that place. So this was the story about the Alice and the mouse. So once again, I want to recall a small story. I want to recall that about this story, so that you can find easily, you can understand easily. So it is a small story about Alice and the mouse. Okay, Alice is a little girl who wanted to get into the beautiful garden, but due to her height, she couldn't go in. And after drinking water, eating cake, he became a small teeny girl and get into the garden. So garden was full of water, and she found herself that she was swimming in that pond. And after some time, a small creature, that mouse gets slipped into that pond, and both were stuck into that pond. And after some time, they get out of that pool, where the mouse started telling about his story, that how he had get into that pool. So when he was telling his story, Alice was in different mood. She was not paying attention towards the story of mouse. So it hurt the feelings of mouse, and the mouse left that place. And let's not forget that when mouse was telling his story, other creatures were present there. They were also listening the story. So when the mouse left that place, in the same moment, in the same time, all the creatures that together lived, they called the mouse, but the mouse didn't pay attention towards them and get back to and get away from there. So in that moment, what Alice did, Alice wished about her pet dog, and described about her pet that what he could do. So on listening there, all the party members, those who were present there, they were frightened, and it created a sensation among them, and they were completely afraid of that pet, and they disappeared from that place. at the moment. And once again, Alice got alone. So after some time, a small sound, pattering sound, she heard some pattering sound. She thought that maybe the mouse is coming back to finish his story, but it wasn't so, and she was completely alone there, sitting there. So it was her mistake that if she had not mentioned about her pet, all the members would be with her. So this is the story, small story about Alice and the mouse, that how Alice got stuck there or got alone in that place. So thank you for joining our online classes.